Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's get 3-3 started. And I believe you need two different kinds of powers here. One is actually the stone cutter one that I remember needing. I mean, that I said that I needed to use in a later level. This is the level that I'm talking about, actually. I remember that quite vividly because I had issue. Come on, just kill that thing. Because I had issues with that. This one as a kid. I'll explain to you why when I get there. But I'm trying to remember what the other one is that I need. I think it's cutter plus bomb. So I'm just hoping that I get this right. I guess I'll see once I get there, like when I get to the thing that I need to destroy with whatever I need to destroy with. Hopefully that is the thing. Oh god, trapinch traps all over the place. Well, okay, not all over the place, there's only those two there, and we're good. And now, by the way, notice the beach setting here. Ah, so beautiful. As the volcanoes erupt. But really, this game does have a really nice atmosphere, and they make a lot of use of the many wide variety of atmosphere that you can put in a game. They just keep transitioning you from one area to the next. Look out for the shotzos in the background. Oh no! And really no issue whatsoever. Block my attack, how dare you? Because you can tell, you know, where the cannons are and where they're shooting based on the shadow. It's really easy to tell their pathway. The Kirby 64 does a very good job of letting you see. Oh no, no! Failed there. I forgot I needed one of them. Kirby 64 does a good job in most cases, like with this pseudo 3D of when something is being shot from the background, it gives you a feel of what you would need. I mean, where you would need to not be, basically, to avoid stuff. And man, I'm really so when I use that. Clear the way. Clear the way. By the way, you can't float when you're using the cutter like this. Yeah, just thought I would mention that. So be careful when you use the cutter power. Just saying. Needless to say, we are transitioning from the beach to the ocean. Oh god. You are a bomb though, aren't you? If I recall correctly. Yes, you are. Maybe I shouldn't have pulled this out so quickly. I need to combine the powers of an explosive blowfish and a blade of death. At least I think. I'm just getting this just in case, because I know the powers are here. There we go. And grab it before it disappears. Man, he just sucked in a lot of water there. But then again, Kirby's a bottomless pit, so you don't have to worry about him whatsoever. By the way, Ninja Stars! Yeah, they actually stick into enemies and things. It's kind of brutal if you think about it. Oh, nothing there to stick into. You can't actually see them on the screen as per the feel of a ninja. Oh yeah, I forgot some of these actually fly upwards. Ones with the stars above them, as you can see there's a shadow. Yeah, they're supposed to be like trapped, but they actually are kind of helpful. you want to go inside here, and I believe this is where you need to use the bomb plus cutter. See this over here on the side? This mossy-looking thing? I had no idea what this was. I mean, I was so stumped the first time I played this game, or played through this game, because it just didn't look like anything out of the ordinary. Yeah, you actually need the power of ninja to get in there. And I was correct about needing bomb plus cutter. Oh. I'm gonna need another cutter then, aren't I? Because I need to combine. Can I go back? Because I know I can get a cutter enemy from the other area, but I rarely can go back in areas, as I said before. I just don't want to. Oh, I can, wow. Maybe you can go back in more areas than I thought you could in this game. So I'm gonna go back, get myself a cutter somewhere. And I should. How far back do I have to go, though? Oh, here we go. I'm just gonna destroy that. Ditch that. No! He jumped right in my projectile. How could you do such a thing? And he's back. Yeah. This shouldn't be that difficult. You don't die when you hit the water, do you? Okay, I didn't think so. Enemies in this game don't quite react like they do in other Kirby games. And I didn't... or at least I don't remember seeing a rock enemy along the way. Then again, I was unobservant on that other level in the last part when it came to rock enemies. But I need a rock. Or stone, actually, is called the stone power. Don't hurt me. Alright. We are golden. With a little bit of backtracking, I suppose. Levels do tend, for the most part, to give you all the powers you need to 100% them, but sometimes it's just easier getting a power in another level. Like, as I showed you at 1-2, that level right there is a flurry of powers that you can get in that one level. I should probably go above these Gordos, because each one has a trap plank underneath it. There we go! Yeah! Alright. Now you're going to see why we need to use this in just a minute, and it's a really puzzling one to use as well. Hey, DDD, how's it going? Woo! Thank you, actually, that worked out in my favor. This was another one that baffled me on my first playthrough, because when I first played this game, I didn't play any other Kirby games, so I had no knowledge of what the powers of all these critters that you could make were, and you can pretty much tell if you've played Kirby 64 how baffling this would have been to someone who never played Kirby's Dream Land 3 or any of the games that had those critters. Oh, that one sinks in the water. I didn't know that, actually. I usually just floated over this one. I just went in the water that time to get the sandwich. Anything back here? Well, besides the enemy. And, oh, this still isn't it, dang it! You know what, this works. I can just jump very, very slowly, and no! Can I go back? Thank you! It's gone! No, I didn't know that was where it was gonna fall, I thought it was gonna be the center. No! I missed the second one. Well, temporarily. Okay, see that one over there? Here, this is why it is baffling. The first thing is, because this is underwater, it's kind of hard to tell, especially... Well, okay, it's not as hard to tell as I thought it was back when I was a kid. It might have been because I was using a really poor colored TV, but this, I thought, was green and red back when I was a kid, and I was wondering why I couldn't get through this, so it's actually green and brown. But now, once you get through this... Oh shoot, I actually had the right one. Well, it's fine. I'll have to show you the explanation anyway. You try to float up there. You try your best to float up there. You will never ever make it. It's way too far away. So, what do? You gotta transform into Rick. Not that. And it's totally random too. Not that. And, oh, no, wait, it's not... Wait, it is Rick, because he can grab onto the walls. Okay. And you can just jump off the wall like this an unlimited amount of time. And this sort of thing is completely baffling when you don't know the powers of these critters. There we go. There's the crystal shard. And let's go down. By the way, those... spiky log enemies up there. It's interesting. They're actually an enemy known as Splinter. So, I guess they're technically living? Technically? It's... Oh, and those platforms. They don't move by your weight. They move as you're getting close to them, I think. Oh, no, wait. They do. But they only move down when you're so-and-so close to them. My mistake. No, it doesn't seem they trigger differently. It depends on the situation, I suppose. So yeah, those logs, they know what they're doing. They know exactly what they're doing. I'm not even bothering to get the stars along the way there. I think this is the end of the level here. Yep. Let's get a card. Hopefully, yeah. And now I gotta go through the entire level again, just for that one shard. Look at that. Look at that! The second one! And it was right on my fingertips, if only I didn't get trap-holed. It's true what they say, down is death. Even in Yu-Gi-Oh! Oh, I just barely made it there. Alright, here we are. Let's not screw it up this time, since I know where I'm supposed to be. You know, when there's not going to be a trap hole trap card waiting for me. And there we go. There's the shard. Now, let's finish this dang level. Card time! No! But that's okay. The level is complete, so let's go to the next one, 3-4. Swimming. It's beautiful. And I'm just gonna sink all the way to the bottom. By the way, those torpedo guys are actually called pedos. It's like a slang name in on themselves. Kind of interesting if you ask me. And there we go. Rock really speeds you up, you know, getting all the way to the bottom there. And just be on the lookout for shards. I don't believe there were any in that first area. Are you frightened of me, fish? No, you're just synchronized swimming. This is kind of neat, actually. You've got this pathway that you're following, so you can actually tell where you are in the sea of rocks here, where, you know, like where they're going to fall and stuff like that, without actually... Oh, shoot! I could not control very well. I totally fail with my controls there. But I like that, like, crevice in the ocean there, still with that little pathway indicating where you are going to be. I just found that kind of neat, if you ask me. And there's torpedoes coming out of the sand for whatever reason. You can't really explain this, but you probably shouldn't try to explain it, because, you know, crushing the game logic could cause a universal implosion, pardon me. Or an explosion. You never know. I mean, never happened before, right? Yeah. Perhaps we will never know. Perhaps. I don't think there were any shards in that area, actually. I think there is one in here, though. Yeah, there is. You gotta look out for the Gordos in this area. Go up to the top. I think you're actually supposed to work your way back down, too, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, yep. I was right. Oh, no, wait. I can't go back. No. Well, you know what? I might as well just restart the level and I'll see you back at that spot. Such beauty. Such beauty. This game really does have a very nice atmosphere. Alright, remember to go up the left side and the left side only. I forgot about this current at the top completely. Duh. That was my downfall. I should probably start over here. I just got stuck on something for whatever reason. Yeah, there we go. Now I can continue without any worry. Well, there's gonna be some worry, I'm sure. I mean, we're fighting against the current here. You can't trust the current. Although you can control it a little bit. By rockifying yourself, as if you have that power. This would be helpful. Because now I can run through everything. I was hoping to get that. I think you would knock me out of my power, though. Because you are explosive. Shard. Well, this is going to be... Oh, I was gonna say easy to get if I have my shard, but I have to get out of my power to grab onto the pole. Yeah, it's number two. Go. Oh! Would like my birdie buddy again. I need to carve... forget it. This is gonna take too long. Actually, I think this is a little bit faster in general, because I'm faster than the enemy's projectiles anyway. Like, they appear on screen, but they aren't fast enough to shoot at you most of the time anyway, so it's not like you need to be invincible, except for maybe there. oh, boss time! Yeah! Oh, jeez. That totally did not go as planned. Or maybe it did, and I was just fooling you. Walk into my form. Or, you know what, this actually works. Where? I thought Shard appears in this room, or maybe it doesn't. No? Oh, wait. Was I supposed to do that? I hope I was. Because there's a bunch of exits there, and yeah. Wait a second! Meat! Yeah, I think actually this is where it is. I mean, the last crystal shard of the level. You'll notice that there's rocks and a current. The crystal shard, I believe, is in one of those little alcoves like that. And it might be handy to be in rock form as I'm going through this, actually. Because I can resist the current. I still need a more mobile power. That one is useless. I said mobile, not immobile. There we go. Okay, Gordo's out of my way. And that just pops right on my body without any issue whatsoever. Rest your wings every once in a while because you can't fly infinitely. There it is. It's right in plain sight too. I don't think I had to worry about this at all. I should say worry about getting in there at all. So there's the last one. And I actually think this is going to be the last level I'll be playing this part, based on what I see on ye ol' camera. This would be a lot harder if I wasn't in rock form, I can tell you that. And there's the exit! Yeah, and I do believe... That was weird. Actually, I had to pop me out of that form, and I do believe that in that room with the boss, that was the only exit, the other ones were just detailing. No, I'm short! I'm short! Well, with that failure, yet a successful run on the level, I hope you enjoyed this part, and I will see you in the next part!